Here. Boy.
It says, glory to Mjolnir, the Dwarf King. May his reign be long, prosperous, and filled with peace.
Greetings, and welcome to Konungsgard. I just want to make sure you're good and prepared before heading in any further. There's all manner of nastiness left over from the Mad Dwarf King's foul practices.
What kind of practices?
Oh, various sacrificing, dark enchantments, blood, magic, and so forth. Quite common among the older dwarves, unfortunately. Old habits are hard to break.
Whoa. Look, a dragon! But it's chained. Is it a pet?
Do not get any ideas.
Ready yourself!
I believe the chain is the only thing holding him down.
Odds are there's a bit of magic at play here as well. This is a dwarven stronghold, after all.
Oh!
That's an impressive front door. These materials must be pretty special to make legendary armor.
This legendary armor better be worth the trouble.
But if Brock and Sindri make it together, I'm sure it's worth the effort. Don't you trust them at least?
I trust you, Atreus. I do not trust the legend.
Oh. In these three entry stones.
Oh!
yourself, boy.
One vicious son of a bitch.
There he is. Or, see him? Are these boy or girl dragons?
I do not know.
There are a few ways to find out, but they're rather messy.
I guess it doesn't matter.
Dragon would be a bit more supportive, seeing how we're trying to beat
it.
It is over. Here. Boy.
Yes, sir. This is good to know. Number two, this place is even bigger than Vadergar.
Yes, the Dwarf King's reach appears vast.
Wonder what happened to him.
It is a great mystery, even amongst the sons of Ivaldi. Mozognir's behavior before his disappearance grew increasingly erratic.
Why?
The Dvegrath Eaker, the very armor you find yourself searching for. Though he found two, I'd wager his failure to find the third ingredient drove him to madness.
Atreus, to me!
I'm coming! Still won't open? Looks like we need three.
Yeah. strong then. Keep your guard up.
Something over there.
Thank you.
Focus up.
Changing arrows. Why did the Dwarf King want this armor so badly? What's so special about it?
There are many legends behind the Dvegrath Eker. A suspicious amount of legends, which makes confirming anything about this particular armor difficult. The one constant among them is the ability of the armor to offer ultimate protection. A useful attribute for an unpopular king, you see.
Yet this...
We're in! Okay. Here we go! Huh. It's kind of run down in here.
What did you expect?
I don't know. Less ruin, I guess? Maybe the throne room's in better shape.
Here, boy. Another one.
Starcather. Wow. That's a lot of arms.
That's fair to say.
Six? Seven? Eight? Could he shoot four bows at once?
More of a swordsman. He did only have the two eyes.
Looks like Thor cut him down to size.
It's what he does.
Do you hear that?
No. What do you hear, boy?
Crying. And screams. Large crowd of people.
Just old spirits, I suppose. Leftover victims of the Mad Dwarf's reign. Still, that's rather ominous.
They're getting louder. They sound almost like... Hellwalker!
Hey, look at this. A blood trail.
Where's a passage behind this throne?
A secret passage!
Well, wouldn't be a proper throne room without a secret passage.
Maltzignir.
Boy, over here.
Yes, sir. Wonder who wrote this. This must be the three mythical ingredients Brock was talking about.
I can say with utmost certainty that I've never laid eye on a stranger set of objects in my life.
How are Brock and Sindri supposed to build with... whatever they are?
Don't count the dwarves out, lad. They're right pricks, but they're resourceful. They once made an unbreakable chain out of little more than a cat's footstep and... bird spit.
That doesn't even make sense.
Well, that's the legend. If you want it sense, you shouldn't be talking to a severed head.
You found the legendary materials? Incredible. Oh, this is so exciting. Meet me back at the temple and we'll get started right away.
Bifrost crystals in your eyes.
A loving gift from the giants. Since I used to do so much traveling between realms, they thought it would be more convenient for me than having a crystal I could lose.
Did it hurt?
No, because I wisely fortified myself with 16 cups of Billow Maiden's ale. Got so inebriated, I tried convincing the giants to put them in my nipples instead. Almost talked them into it too. Can you imagine? Mimir of the Bifrost teats. Those were the days.
Ew.
Okay, I'll stop now.
You boys look right beaming. Well, the squirt.
We found the materials. But they're so weird. How do you build a piece of armor out of something so...
Nanya.
Nanya?
None your fucking business. Trade secret. We got our ways.
Oh.
How was your trip to Jotunheim?
Will you give them a little privacy? The kid just found out he's a giant. He doesn't need you interrogating.
Bruh, you knew?
Oh, we knew Faye was the last guardian of the Jotnar left in Midgard. That's why we made her the axe. We hoped to restore the balance of power.
After Thor went all breezer with our hammer.
Though in the end, it seems, she chose another path. She chose, well, you. Both of them. I suppose she figured that was the best chance for the giants to live on. And now, I suppose, that's up to you.
How about that? A young Jotun with us the whole time.
I'm the son of Laufey, the just! I should have seen it before!
Let's get to it. Maybe next time.
Better not be fighting with your brother again.
Just because he's gotten a little less annoying over the years doesn't mean I ain't got a customer base of my own to keep happy.
Oh, yeah? Who's that?
Well, you came back here, didn't you?
Fair point.